In this video, I want to introduce the concept of back surface field, which is many times also abbreviated as BSF, and how this BSF can essentially reduce the surface recombination. So it can reduce the surface recombination at the back surface of the solar cell. So it can reduce the surface recombination at the back surface. So we want to understand what this BSF is and how the heck it does reduce the surface recombination at the back surface. So first, I want to illustrate where this problem of surface recombination comes in the solar cell. So I've drawn this solar cell, which is made on this p-type silicon wafer. So there's an N plus emitter layer on the top of towards the top of the solar cell, and there are these metallic fingers which are connecting to these emitter, and connecting to the base is this contact at the back, which could be aluminum. And what I've done further is that I've taken this cross section of this solar cell, and I've taken the liberty of rotating it by 90 degrees, and I've drawn it over here. So the light would be shining from the top, and in this picture is toward from this direction, and that essentially produces these electrons and hole pairs throughout the solar cell. So to illustrate, to understand any semiconductor device, it's always best to draw the band diagram. So let me draw the band diagram of this solar cell. So I have this N plus emitter, and then I have this P base. So I have this P base towards the back, and then I'll connect these bands, and that would give me the band diagram of my solar cells. So I want to collect my electrons on the emitter side, on the N plus side over here, and I want to collect my holes on this P side if I want to use this solar cell to produce electricity. But on the other hand, simultaneously, I'm generating these holes in this N plus region as well, and I'm generating these electrons in this P plus region as well. So now these holes which are present in the emitter region, or these electrons which are present in the base region, they can now reach the surface, and the surface has this large density of surface traps that we talked about in one of the previous videos. And if this minority carrier, this electron, reaches the surface, it can now essentially recombine. It can use this trap state present on the surface, and it can annihilate the electron and hole pair. It can recombine with the hole using this surface state. Similarly, this hole which reaches the surface can again now annihilate, or it can get recombined. So usually on the front side, at least on the emitter side, people put a very good passivation using silicon oxide, or a combination of silicon oxide, nitride, silicon nitride, and which also serves as a good anti-reflection coating. But this is especially a big problem at the back contact. And not only will this this electron will recombine with the hole pair as well, but it could have been an electron which could have been collected on the emitter side. So all the electrons which are generated in the depletion region, so let's say this would be my depletion region, plus a vicinity of one or two diffusion length away from the distribution. So let's say this is my diffusion length in my p-type semiconductor. So all these electrons which were generated in this depletion region, plus this distance of one diffusion length away from the depletion region, could have been collected on the emitter side. And if this diffusion length was greater than this distance which my contact is, so if this diffusion length was large, then this is again, the problem is even worse, because I could have easily collected this electron on the emitter side. So there is need to repel this electron away from the surface, or keep it away from this back surface. And the idea which is used is a very simple idea, and it's even simpler to realize. And let me illustrate the way this idea is realized by drawing this p-n junction again. So again, I have my my n plus emitter, and I have this p base. What I do on the back is I add this p plus layer, or this heavily doped p plus layer at the back. And let me again, to understand it, I need a band diagram. Pretty much to understand any semiconductor device, I need a band diagram. So I need to illustrate what happens using this band diagram. So again, I have this N plus layer over here, and I have this P layer, I have this P base layer, and this is my band diagram. And let me draw it for the case of no applied voltage and no light shining. So this would be my Fermi level, which is in equilibrium. And now what happens at the back? So now at the back, I've added this P plus layer. So my band towards the back is essentially would bend something like this. So, I have this P plus layer. So my valence band will move even closer to the Fermi level. So my band diagram would look something like this. So now let me think of those electron and hole pairs again. And let me draw the surface states which exist as well. So now I have these electrons and hole pairs generated over here. So I have this electrons and hole pairs generated over here. Electrons love to travel down the hill. So all these electrons which are present in this depletion width, plus some diffusion length away from this depletion width would all be collected. So this is my depletion width, and then a distance of diffusion length away from this depletion width. So all these electrons over here, they would be collected. They love to go down the hill, and they will be collected on my emitter contact. Similarly, my holes, which are generated in this region, would be again collected on this base contact. So my problem was that this electron was instead, it could go to the surface in this previous case. So in this previous case, this electron could go on the surface, and it can get recombined. So now let's understand what I've done by introducing this P plus layer over here. So if I've introduced this P plus layer over here, my band diagram is of this shape, where I've created this this upward facing slope towards the surface. So now this electron is essentially, it's repelled from going near the surface by this field which is created as a result of having this P plus layer. And also this P plus layer, it helps in collecting these holes towards my base contact, because this essentially, the holes love to travel up the hill, and electrons love to travel down the hill. So by creating this upward facing hill over here, I'm repelling these electrons away from the surface. And this is what my back surface field is. So this is my back surface field. So now by creating this P plus region over here, I've created this field towards the back surface. And this is now this field. Let me, zoom. If I zoom in the band over here, the presence of this field over here, this is repelling these electrons from reaching the back surface. And there are several ways I can realize this back surface field. The most common and the most easiest way to realize that this P plus doping to create this back surface field. So I want to create this P plus doping in this region. So the easiest way to do that is to alloy this aluminum from the back, and this aluminum act as a decent p-type dopant in silicon, and it creates this P plus layer towards the back, which repels the electrons from reaching the back surface. The other way to create this back surface field would be again to introduce boron, to do a implant or a diffusion of boron from the back surface to create this back surface field as well. So in summary, this presence of this P plus layer at the back, it creates this surface field. And that surface field, it repels the minority carriers away from the back surface, and it helps in reducing the surface recombination towards the back surface. So hopefully you're able to understand this back surface field, and whenever you see this term BSF, you'll understand what's happening.